Hey fellow beauty finders, this is Matthias Allen. Thanks for clicking on my new video. So for those of you who are brand new to my channel, I do 3 weekly demos, tutorials, tips, and tricks from Hollywood, California. So I hope you will subscribe, and I hope you'll click thumbs up if you enjoy this video, and leave a comment down below. So today I want to talk about touching up your makeup after having it on for hours and hours and hours. Okay, I want to share with you some tips and tricks for touching up your makeup. It's very important to know exactly how to touch it up without looking like a cake face at the end of the night. And if you don't have time to completely redo it before you have to start your second or third part of the day, I'm going to show you some great tips and tricks with some of my favorite products. So I got up this morning at probably about 7:30. I had a couple hours of work to do before I had to put my face on, and then at 10 o'clock I had to leave the house and drive for about an hour to go to a private makeup lesson in Southern California, about 30 miles from my house. So I put this face on very early this morning. That I love the Kat Von D Locket Foundation. The Kat Von D Locket Foundation is probably one of my all-time favorite foundations ever. It's incredible. It's very mattifying when I first put it on. I love, 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 love the way it goes on. It gives me a great full coverage. I do a little bit of spot concealing. It's really all around just a great foundation for my skin type because I am very oily. As you can see, I have a lot of shine on my skin, and I'm gonna show you how to touch that up. If you guys wanna see a live demo of how this goes on, let me know in the comments down below. And if enough of you request that video, I will do it for you on camera. It's about 7 hours later. It's late in the afternoon. I've got somewhere to be later on tonight, so I need to do a makeup touch-up. I don't want to wipe off everything that I already have on and start fresh, but I'm very oily and I'm very greasy. I don't recommend right off the bat taking a pressed powder and completely just obliterating my face with colored touch-up pressed powder, because what's going to happen is all of this oil that's right in here and right in here is going to suck up the colored pressed powder. So you definitely don't want to do that right off the bat. You need to do a couple different steps before that. Okay, so really quick and easy, the first thing that I recommend is taking a latex-free sponge and trying to mattify any of the areas of your face that are greasy or shiny after having foundation and concealer on for a few hours. Now, taking a latex-free sponge, which is dry, not wet, is actually going to help push any foundation or concealer that may be creasing from wearing all day long. It's actually going to help push it back into the pore and kind of manipulate it so that I don't have to put on so much powder at the end. Now, this is the first step for a basic touch-up, and it's really strongly recommended that you do that first. Once I completely mattify my face with just the dry sponge, I then go and I take a look and I see, do I need any touch-ups? Are any of my freckles, moles, pimples, whatever is happening that day or that week, do I need a little touch-up? So I'm gonna show you the NARS Biscuit Medium Concealer. Now, this is a great concealer. I love this on the eyes. I love this on blemishes. A little bit goes a long way. If there is any freckling or moles or pimples that are kind of shining through by the end of the day, discoloration, especially from sun damage, is very, very, very hard to cover up. It really is. And I have a lot of sun damage. I'm gonna do another video vlog about the importance of sunscreen and how sun damage has really affected my life. So make sure you subscribe because that's gonna be coming up in just a few short weeks. Another place on my face, and I'm sure yours, that the makeup tends to kind of disappear by the end of the day is around the nose area, because, you know, we blow our noses, we pick our noses. If you're like me, you know, you have a runny nose sometimes because it's allergy season. So I like to take a little bit of the touch-up concealer and make sure that my entire nose area is retouched. And then lastly, if you want to do a little touch-up just under the eye, it's great to do a little bit of concealer just on the inner corners right here. And then right here, if you're not wearing too much eyeshadow, also just kind of brighten up the eye by popping like that. Okay, so if your foundation is a complete and utter disaster, and it's completely separating, like all the continents, hundreds of thousands of years ago, separating from one continent into 7 different continents, what you should do is reapply some of your foundation, but don't just do this over separated foundation. You want to take a product like Ultramatte from Face Atelier. Now this is a fantastic product. It's a liquid silicone. There's nothing else like this on the market. It's fabulous. This is almost like taking a liquid primer and just giving yourself a mist. So what you can do with this is just give yourself two slight mists of that liquid silicone. Give yourself a veil of that. Then go in with your latex-free sponge or your foundation sponge from earlier on in the day when you applied your foundation and literally mattify and push all that product together. And maybe even take a little bit of foundation on the back of your hand, very, very, very lightly, and push that back into the skin and make sure that all those continents that have been separating all day are now melded together with the help of something like this. Okay, so lastly, I want to powder because I want to look matte. I like a matte finish. If you guys don't like a matte finish, then that's okay, that's cool. But a little bit of powder goes a long way. You don't have to overdo it. Most people like to carry a compact in their purse, something like this from Urban Decay, which is the Naked Skin Naked Medium Ultra Definition Pressed Finishing Powder. Now this actually has a little bit of color, and this is a great way to do a touch-up if you want to add a little bit more coverage to your skin. But if you really can afford the extra room in your bag, I would prefer you use loose powder. Loose powder is always going to give you a much softer matte finish without looking heavy or cakey. So I like the Urban Decay Naked Skin Ultra Definition Loose Powder in medium. I also want to show you, this is from Pure Cosmetics. This is the Balancing Act Shine Control Powder. Now this is phenomenal for somebody who doesn't want to add any color to their skin at all. This is mattifying. It has spheres in here which will mattify your entire face without adding any more color. So that is another great option for you to try. So I'm going to take my Urban Decay Naked Ultra Definition Loose Powder. I'm going to go right into the T-zone first. To make sure that all of those areas, especially in the middle of the face where I get oiliest, are mattified and sealed in after I've done my little touch-up with my extra concealer or foundation, if that's what you're doing. Now that's the best way to touch up your face because the loose powder is going to be much more finite and airbrushed looking when you're done. Now if you want to take your pressed powder, which has a little bit of color, that's fine as well. Just know that if you take this much color, which has been pressed into this amount of space, especially like over your cheeks and your forehead, you're going to lose all of the shimmer, all of the strobing, and all of the blush, which you spent half an hour doing earlier today. So just be aware. Okay, and that's it. So if you guys have any questions, leave them down below in my comment section. I love hearing from my followers and fans. And if you haven't already subscribed to my channel, please do so now by clicking on the link right down here for 3 brand new pro artist tips, tricks, videos, and vlogs every single week. If you want to see one of my other makeup demos where I've taken a model or an actress into my chair and showed you step by step exactly how to do what I do best, then check out one of these other 2 videos right here, which are suggested for you, and make sure you follow me on all social media at Matthias for Makeup. I'm having a lot of fun on Snapchat, so make sure you check me out there. And I'm doing live Periscope feeds as well. If you don't have the Periscope app, you need to get it. And I will talk to you soon, maybe next week or later on this week, because there's another video coming right out. Okay, bye for now.